Hi, everyone. Thank you for coming to my talk. Today, I'll be presenting SAWSense. I first want to quickly contextualize this work within a vision for intelligent surfaces. There has been a lot of work looking at how to enable gesture interfaces on surfaces, such as recognizing swipes happening on the surface of a table, and additionally towards ubiquitous sensing, like understanding what activities are happening in the home. And most recently, there's been work towards computational materials, such as having the actual fabric of a couch be part of the fabric of computation. In all these cases, we want to look and feel the objects to remain the same. So how do we get there? At a physical level, there are generally three types of waves that are launched when a finger or an object hits the surface. There are surface acoustic waves that travel along two dimensions on the surface of the material. There are traditional bulk vibrations that travel through the entirety of the material. And there are sound waves that travel through the air. However, there have been some challenges with detecting surface events with previously used sensors. Each sensor type has had to consider some trade-offs. For example, microphones, which are easy to deploy and very sensitive, have had to deal with also capturing environmental noise. Accelerometers that are robust to that noise and easy to deploy end up having limited bandwidth and range. And geophones, while sensitive and also robust to noise, are bulky and must be vertically oriented. This work explores the possibilities of using VPUs, which sense surface acoustic waves that embody all three of these characteristics. VPUs are voice pickup units, and they were originally designed as bone conduction mics for in-ear headphones. They were designed to pick up waves that travel through the body while rejecting in-ear sounds from the environment. VPUs add a sealed mass spring to a traditional MEMS microphone, which transduce surface acoustic waves to pressure waves that can be picked up by that microphone. This allows you to have the bandwidth and sensitivity of microphones while only capturing surface acoustic waves and not in-ear sounds. We repurpose these sensors to capture saws on a variety of surfaces. In this paper, we performed a robust comparison of four different sensors, but here we're going to demonstrate one to provide an intuition to the advantages of VPUs. Here, a fingernail makes a single tap on a wooden workbench while news is playing on a speaker in the environment. Only a VPU and a microphone can produce a high resolution capture of the nail tap, yet the microphone is also capturing background noise, the news playing, highlighted in yellow. For a more direct example, we will play two clips where a person taps and swipes on a desk 1.8 meters away from the sensor while music is playing in the room. Here, the first clip is a traditional microphone. And here's SAWSense in the same scene. In short, SAWSense provides a unique sensor that is robust to noise, yet is very expressive, even when the event is at a distance from the sensor. We'll now talk about how we evaluate SAWSense across two domains of HCI, gesture recognition and activity recognition. We first evaluate SAWSense as a gesture input system. We selected three subtle gestures, finger tap, swipe, and fling, and also evaluated their fingernail equivalents, which are more in line with prior works. The figures on the right show each gesture and the frequency signature, showing how each gesture's signature is visibly separable. We performed a 10-user user study on a wooden table, including persons with long nails and acrylic nail extensions. We found promising results. We first performed a teasing analysis, which is one way to represent how separable each class is. From this plot, we see very good clusters with slight overlap from the more subtle finger fling and nail fling gestures. Our confusion matrix corroborates these results, having the most confusion between nail fling and finger fling. Overall, we found a greater than 97% per user accuracy and an across user accuracy with augmentation, the details of which can be seen in the paper. In this clip, we'll demonstrate SAWSense's real-time predictions with the laptop actively classifying the gestures, starting with finger tap, finger swipe, finger fling, nail tap, nail swipe, and nail fling. We also evaluate SAWSense's ability to recognize activities in the kitchen. We selected 16 various appliances, objects, and actions, each of which have a visually distinct frequency signature. They were evaluated both on a wooden counter and a metal kitchen island as a 10-round, leave one round out evaluation. We evaluate SAWSense in a similar way to our gesture evaluation, First, looking at our teasing plot, the categories can be seen to be well separated, which matches our intuition given how different, for example, an air fryer is to a water boiler. We found over 99% accuracy for both wood and metal surfaces and performed a preliminary evaluation generating synthetic features from one material for another material and found 98% accuracy. Additionally, since SAWSense is robust to environmental noise, we can perform real-time classification of kitchen events even when music starts to play in the background.
Hey Google, play classical.
Got it. Here's a Spotify playlist called Classical Essentials.
So in the previous two evaluations, we looked at more traditional sensing modalities on rigid 2D surfaces like tables, but we knew how expressive VPUs are and we wanted to explore where else SAWSense could be used. By placing only one VPU on each of these objects, we can enable multiple kinds of interactions, like making the entire curved surface of a coffee machine touch sensitive, or supporting playful interactions on a toy with a textured 3D printed bone, or by placing them on speakers that are actively playing music. Or on soft surfaces like a fabric couch to make the arm touch sensitive. Or on the sleeve of a jacket to enable wearable applications. Given the length of this talk, I wanted to highlight some of the things in this paper that we couldn't get to. We did an information power analysis to craft custom features for SAWS. We detail our augmentation approaches to boost across user accuracy. We looked at how to generalize SAWSense across materials, so metal to wood or wood to metal. And we performed our evaluations with multiple machine learning approaches, showing that SAWSense is machine learning invariant. And finally, we looked at a lightweight SAWSense that in the future could be deployed on microprocessors. In conclusion, surface acoustic waves present a novel sensing approach that uses a small and easy to deploy VPU, where the wide bandwidth enables rich activity recognition in addition to gesture sensing, and when paired with a lightweight machine learning algorithm, can imbue intelligence on even simple objects like toys and jackets. Finally, I want to thank my brilliant collaborators, Yves Zhao, Kenrick Kin, and Alanson Sample. Thanks for coming to my talk.